Welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher. Just found out, called this Napoleon, who's an informant of Jean's. We basically stumbled onto that one. It was printed on Harry's brandy bottle. So we called a number. And then we looked it up here, Napoleon, and found clues as to what the password is. And, Napoleon has agreed to meet us at the Alton Plaza at the EXG District. It'll take us quite some time to get to that, because we're going to check out the detective's room, and I guess we're heading for Jean's house. So let's go to detective's room. Alright, let's check out Gibson's room. This is the detective's room. We should investigate John's personal items. Must learn what he was doing before he was killed. I see. Basic detective work. The near desk is his. Look, investigate. Yeah, possession. Right. It's an antique steel desk. This is the one that Jean was using. Should probably take a look inside, eh? This is a locker that Jean was using. So his personal things should be in there, right? So naturally investigating, looks inside. It's an old style working desk. It has drawers installed. There's only one drawer. Can I look at drawer? I can. There's a keyhole on the front. A key? Nobody uses keys anymore. We're holding a key. As I recall, Jean had a key. Hello, we have the key. There's a keyhole on the front. I'm afraid it's locked. I cannot open it. We'll use the key. Just hold on a second, guys. Let's investigate the locker first. Alright, let's investigate the locker. There's a coat hanging inside the locker. There's nothing in the locker besides the coat. It's John's junker coat. This was probably a spare. Just like the coat I got, but a little bigger. It's really worn out, though. Check the pockets of the coat for me, will you? Alright, Metal Gear says. A chess piece was in the coat. Anything else? There's nothing else in the coat. It's a chess piece. Made of wood. This could mean something, Metal. Let's hang on to it as evidence. Alright, I will store this chess piece as evidence. I'm sure it must mean something. Oh, we can't... Oh, it's in possessions now. It's a chess piece that we found in Gibson's coat. Chess piece. Alright, nothing else about the chess piece. Oh. Now I have use in place of show. All that's there is key. Alright, I will try the key. There was something in a drawer. Capsules. And a disc. Hmm. talking about the keyhole. We already investigated the drawer. Just making sure there's nothing else in there. And a capsule. It's some kind of capsule medication. It's a floppy disk for a personal computer. Still using floppy disks? In what, 2070 something? It's a 5-inch floppy disk. 5-inch disk? Nobody uses those things anymore. This disk must have something to do with Jean's investigation. Well, Jean is into old keys and old disks. Alright, I will store this disk as evidence.
What kind of medicine is this?
I'll perform an analysis. Acid inhibitors, membrane protecting agents, H2 blockers. This is medication for an ulcer.
Jeez. It looks like Jean's stomach was really in terrible shape. And what was he doing eating buffalo? That seems a little unusual. Perhaps there was some reason that he had to eat buffalo.
These capsules may have something to do with all this. Let's keep them. That will not be necessary. I have recorded the results of the analysis of their chemical composition. Okay. I've already analyzed that. Nothing else in the coat. Alright. You still have the key. The key to Gibson's desk. I'm used to in games where you use a key to unlock something and it, for some reason, disappears. I guess we're done in here. So I wonder if we can use the disk in the computer room? I will close the drawer to the desk. Better shut the locker. Does it really matter? In the slot she goes. Where can I use this disc? Maybe the chief will have an idea? How's your investigation going? Any leads yet? Yeah, good idea. Let's ask about Napoleon first. That's the informant that Gibson was using. Only he knew anything about him. I don't know. There's so much information available anywhere these days. I wouldn't trust those informants. Oh, that's right. You might find something in Jordan. I did. Buffalo Cuisine Restaurant. A place which serves buffalo? Sorry, I can't help you on that one. But the analysis showed it had been about 3 hours since he ate it, so we know the place must be within a 3-hour travel radius of where he was, right? True, good thinking. I've never heard of any registered place with that name, but it could be some underground joint. Let's show him the chess piece. Chess piece, huh? Never played the game. That's right. Harry may know something. Okay. Oh. Do that. If I show him again. Okay, let's show the disc. If you can read that disc, it might provide you with some valuable information. Right, but with what can I read it? Where? Gibson may have stored something about his investigation on this. Do I need to find an antique computer or something like that? Alright, let's head to engineering room. Sniff, sob. I'm afraid we'll make little progress here. He is severely intoxicated. Guess I can't show him this stuff, can we? No. I don't think we can do anything here until he sobers up. This is impeding my investigation. Okay, back to the front? Back to the front! This is a song I haven't heard for a while. She's good now! I'm alright now, Gillian. You can't stay depressed over these things forever. Gillian, I heard you were hurt. Are you alright? Is it getting better? Yeah. Those nanomachines are really doing the trick. Oh, I'm so glad to hear that. Physically, I'm fine, but my heart is still in great pain. Oh, sure. I know what you mean, Gillian. What? What's the matter, Gillian? Something wrong? You're acting odd, Gillian. I always act odd. You like me, don't you? Go ahead. Confess. Mika, looking at you makes me feel so peaceful and relaxed. Anything else? Mika, you look as beautiful as ever today. He's doing everything but confessing. Just what do you think you're doing investigating her? Just try again. Alright, no. Do something? Oh boy. About Gibson. He was out of the office almost constantly. He kept mumbling something about, I've got those snatchers now, or something like that. He found something useful in John's desk, right? I don't know anything else. He never told me what he was doing. Let's ask about Katrina. I feel so sorry for his daughter. She's all alone now. Gillian, please help her out as much as you can, okay? I'll have to try to remember that. Napoleon. That Chinese informant John was using. He's known him ever since he was a science cop. Well, I've heard about him, but I've never met him. Why don't you arrange to meet him? He may know something. I have. Buffalo? I've never even heard of any places that serve that. Oh, that's right. That informant that Jean was using might know something. Who? Napoleon? Yeah, you're right. He may know. Alright. I don't know what this is. Do something. Smell? Console. Don't worry. I'm going to destroy the Snatchers. Yes, I believe you, Gillian. That's what Gillian said. Smell? That's a really great scent. Metal Gear says, if you keep this up, she will probably dislike you immensely. I may be leaning in that direction already, she says. we've removed that from the menu. So how about a date tonight? I don't think we know each other well enough yet. Oh, come on. That doesn't matter. Gillian, you may not know this, but there's a certain order in which things are supposed to happen. You've really got a short temper, haven't you? Listen, Gillian, you want me to go out with you, right? Well, yeah. I really go for men who work hard, you know what I mean? How about I think about it after you finish this investigation? Ooh, you got me there. I can't believe you keep this up, even after T'Chief yelled at you the other day. She is right, you know, Gillian. Who asked you? I like to keep my private life out of the office. I can only get console. Mika, I promise you, I'll finish what Gibson started. You're really a sweet guy, aren't you, Gillian? Okay. Show her... Have I ever shown her the cash? I'm a very high-class woman, you know. If you want to spend time with me, you better have a fat wallet. Seriously? Okay. What are you trying to say? Scrap of paper. What's this? Are you going to buy a house? Pretty mysterious, isn't it? Might have something useful to say. I found this key at the factory ruins. Oh yes, that was Jean's, wasn't it? Okay. What's this? A present for me? Very interesting. Okay, let's show her the disc. I don't know where I can use this disc. What is that? Some computer game disc? Computer, yeah, probably not a game. Although you never know. We do really have no idea what's on it. Okay, I think we're done here then. So what am I... I think I gotta leave the office. I don't think there's anything else. Unless I... Well, she's fine now. Maybe Harry is his name? Is sobered up? Yay! This is engineering. Put the bottle away. I'll just pretend you're Jean and do the best I can. I hear you get hit by those Insectors needle guns. Metal took care of the treatment for me. I've injected several nanomachines to help heal the wounds. Really? Well, they ought to take care of it. And you're still young. You'll get over it quick. Alright, now let's look at stuff. Brandy bottle. It's the bottle that has Napoleon's video phone number on it. I met this guy somewhere. You must really be getting desperate with your investigation. Would you stop that? Hey, that tickles. Hey, watch it. Just who do you think you're investigating? You? Okay, I'm gonna ask him about all kinds of stuff now. Gibson was a little hard-headed like me, but he was a good guy. We were the same age, you know? Gillian says, so that means you're still pretty young. Yeah, when I was young, I was given some brain activity stimulants. One of their side effects is that it speeds the aging process, so I look a little older than I really am.
Oh.
That's right. He was saying things like, we may be able to completely wipe them out soon. Sounds promising. He also said, take care of Katrina if anything happens to me. Speaking of Katrina, the poor, poor girl. After Jean lost his wife, he put everything into his work. Katrina must have been really lonely. That's why she took that model job. She had to have something to help her over it. But now her only friend is Alice. Isn't Alice the wife who died? Oh, it's Jean's dog's name. It was also his wife's name. To tell you the truth, I don't have the slightest. As a matter of fact, I don't know either. Alright, let's ask about Napoleon. An informant? What do you know? Jean was using one of those, wasn't he? Yeah, you actually already knew that. Napoleon, I'll take Japanese sake over that any time. Don't you know either, Harry? Jean was the kind of guy who kept all his secrets pretty well. Buffalo restaurant? I don't eat any of that weird stuff. Nanomachines. They're ultra-small, nano-sized robots. They treat the body's wounds from the inside. So I've got this miniature medical staff hanging around inside of me, huh? It's perfect for someone like you who dislikes doctors, Metal Gear says. Don't worry, they're specially coded so there's no reaction with the body of the host. If you've got nanomachines, you don't ever have to worry about colds or anything. Okay. Show me ID. Gillian, just relax. There's no time limit. Just take your investigation step by step. You think we were surrendering the ID? I'm glad there's no time limit, though. I don't know what you've got in mind, but I'm not interested in women or money. Harry's financial values seem to be somewhat lacking. What are you saying? Money changes people. I don't want any part of that. Scrap of paper. I don't have the slightest what that means. But that's definitely Jean's handwriting. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. The time to quit is when the last of the Snatchers has been wiped off the planet, not before. I don't have the slightest what that means. That's the key to Jean's desk, right? I'll see if he says anything interesting. Evidence? That's a chess piece. Looks like a queen to me. Come on, they're saying you might know something about this. Yeah. Take a look at this, will you? We sure you don't use any 5-inch discs here at Junker HQ. Wait a minute. I'm pretty sure I heard Jean talking about having a PC-68 at home. Hmm. That's right. He's definitely got one at home. I've seen it. How do I leave? Do I go to the front? Hi, Gillian. How's the investigation going? Enter Turbo Cycle. Right. Mika, I'm heading out to check on a few things. I've got a couple of leads. Really? Don't worry yourself over Jean, okay? Thanks, Mika. Gillian? Yes, Mika? How are you and your wife doing? I haven't talked to her in a while. Not even on the video phone? No. Shouldn't leave her alone like that. That's right. Come to think of it, I have her number written down at home. I bet she's pretty lonely. I'm sure you're right. Thanks. Be careful, Gillian. Okay. So I'm gonna go to my home? We've boarded the turbo cycle. Where would you like to go? We gotta go to my home? Or Jean's home? Or somewhere else? Definitely not Alton Plaza yet. Let's go to Gillian's apartment. Alright, now heading to your apartment. Let's hope we're not tailed. Sweet. We've arrived at your apartment. This is your apartment building, Gillian. I know. Wow. You mean I have a place to live, too? Please tone it down, Gillian. I know if you lost your memory, but isn't carrying the act a bit too far? Just trying to make things a little more fun for the folks playing the game. Let's look around. This is the apartment that the government made available for you. The neighborhood's not much, but what a great looking building, huh? We're right on the border between the north and south regions of the city. It's not exactly what you would call the best neighborhood. Can't complain too much. Rent is really high, even around here. It's a 20th century construction, but the building has been completely renovated. Yeah, but I can still hear my next door neighbors all the time. Being right at the dividing line between the north and south regions, the population here is not particularly high. No convenience stores or delis in the area either. Shopping is really a pain. Going inside.